Hey guys and girls, how's it going? Welcome back to another episode of Feed the Beast Regrowth with myself, Lewis. It'd be brilliant having yourself a great day as always. I know what you guys are thinking. You're thinking, isn't it meant to be a Feed the Beast Infinity Day today? Well, I thought we would do a regrowth because I'm currently nursing my hungry node. I'm like a mother hen nursing its new laid egg. Sitting on top and I'm just like, do you need something to eat? Are you still hungry? Are you still here? Have a crafting table. Have a few crafting tables. So while I'm waiting for that to grow, I thought, you know what, we'll do another regrowth. Why not? So in the last episode, we went ahead and we made ourselves the diving gear, which is currently sat here on its very nice little armor stand. And we went and got ourselves some coral rock and some of the ores that we get underneath there. We've got a quest now to go and get some of the natural gas, but we're going to save that for another episode because I don't want to do two episodes in a row where it's very dark. You know, even if I edit it, I watched it back on YouTube and it's still pretty dark, even though I turned the brightness up. And the thing is, if I turn the brightness up too far, it just looks ridiculous. So yeah, I think we'll save that for another episode. But for now, what we're going to do is we're going to run through some more of the quests. Now, I want to do some more witchery, which is going to be pretty cool, but I'd also like to make a blast furnace so that we can start producing steel, because I think that's going to be very, very important for later on. So the sooner we can get that going, the better. So that's going to be the plan. I was also looking at some of these items here. I want to make myself some creeper seeds at some point, and it looks like we can do that. If we have a look inside here, we just need strong essence, and we need a creeper heart. So I'm going to have to probably go and grab myself a creeper heart. We'll make ourselves an Arfana or something and head out, try and beat on some guys. Hopefully we'll be able to get one. If not, I might just make a creeper egg and do it that way. Who knows? But the reason I want to get one of those, which is kind of a sad reason, if I'm being totally honest with you, is because I would like to make a music disc. Because I really miss having music discs. I know it sounds really sad, but I really, really want my music back. And we've got skeleton. We just need creeper and then a little bit of dye, and it gives us a music disc. I thought it'd be a lot more expensive than that. I actually thought there was music disc essence. I don't know why. Something just told me there was, but there isn't, so yeah, I guess we'll be doing that. But let's go on with this blast furnace. We're going to need a few things. It looks like as well, Ron, if you don't know who Ron is, he is Funshine X. I believe he might be doing a series himself. I'm not 100% too sure. But he told me what was crashing me. And generally what happens is when I, before I start recording, I go ahead and I log out. I set up my recording stuff and then I log back in again and I start recording. And it seems like if you log out of your world and log back in again, then you push R to search for a recipe. That's what's crashing me. So this time, instead of logging out and logging back in again, once I've set my recording stuff up, I just totally exited the game and did it that way. So hopefully that's going to do the trick for us. But let's have a look at the blast furnace. We need to make a few of these because we need something like 30 tank blocks or 28, somewhere right about there. And we need sheets of titanium. We need brick construction blocks and infernal bricks. And we need essence of blaze. If we have a look inside our quest book, you'll see that we have got a section here for this in what the world enables, which is blasting off again. I think it tells us here how many we need. We need 34, so we need 34 blast furnace bricks to build the blast furnace. So let's go ahead and do this. We're going to grab ourselves some steel. I'm not sure if this is it. Was that impure titanium? I've been, like, grinding out a load of this titanium. Yeah, here we go. Let's grab some of this. So we're going to have to do this 4 times, I think. It's a bit of a waste because you only actually have to do it 3 times. But, yeah. And we should only need 2 blocks of titanium, I believe. So let's go and take this over to our hammer. We're going to give it a bash in, and hopefully it's going to work. Someone actually posted that there is a way of getting the guy to do this, but I haven't watched the video yet. I'll go and watch that at some point, and then I'll figure out how to do this. But for now, we're just going to beat on it like some sort of heathen, which is probably the funnest way of doing it, I think. So this will give us our titanium plates, shards, something like that. I think we can actually take it out and it shows like the durability of how many times it needs to be beaten before it does the trick. Oh, there we go. All right, so that gives us 8. So let's do it one more time because I believe we need to do this recipe 4 times to get enough. And it's 4 per recipe. So we need to make, you know, we need to do 2 of these to get 16 of these plate majobbies. And then we need to make the infernal bricks. And there's also some things that we have to do with some of the nether essence. Because we need to make some soul sand. We need to make some bricks and things. It's going to be pretty cool. Someone did let me know as well that there is a recipe for clay using the earth and water essence, I think. Which is pretty cool. You know, I'm going to use that. Because I would like to be able to get myself the zombie egg, and to do that I need to make the villager egg first. We might actually do that at the end of today's episode, because I did get myself the emerald seeds and they're kind of growing over here. I want to grab some of these actually, because I want to try and harvest as many of these as possible. We don't need these ones because they've already grown, but we probably want those ones there, so let's leave those in there like that. I haven't got a great deal at the minute because I've only just put them down, so yes, but we're going to want that. We're also going to want to get ourselves some of these guys. We're probably going to want a pretty decent amount of these, so we'll just grab all of them. And let's get ourselves some construction blocks as well, because I think we're going to need a few of those. I made more of those, which is good. And that, hopefully, is going to do the trick for us. We also need blaze, don't we? So let's grab four of those. I think that should do it for us. So, all right, let's see what we can do. So we've got these. We want to make the infernal bricks. The infernal bricks require fitted infernal stone, and the infernal blocks require nether brick and soul sand. So let's go ahead first and make a few of these. We'll make 64 because, well, why not? And we'll also go ahead and make some of the other stuff. I think we can do that with this. Nether bricks. Yeah, we can. Good stuff. So we'll make 64 of those as well. Hopefully that's going to be enough. And let's put these guys together. There we go. We'll get 64 of you. And we need the fitted infernal stone and the infernal bricks. And this should do it for us. Yeah. Nice. Cool beans. All right. So first thing, we should be able to hand this quest in. I get some steel and some titanium, which is pretty big. That can go back in there. Actually, we might as well put all of it back in there. And we've also got steel now as well, which I guess can go in there. I've been, I set this up. Someone said in the comments section I should set up a storage drawer section for all of our metals and ingots and ores and whatnot. So I went and did that. You know, it's kind of cool having it in here, but it does help having it up there. It would be nice if it actually showed how much, though. Like the jabber barrel show how much you've got in there. I know I can look at the whaler tooltip, but I'm pretty sure some of you by now know that I never look at that. I probably should. I know I should, but I never do. All right, so let's do this. So I can't remember if we have to put any lava in it. I don't think we do, but I'm going to take a random guess as to how to build this. I think it's basically the same as the coal coke oven, but a little bit taller. So bring it up like this. There we go. And I think it's that. Yeah, nice. All right, so we can use charcoal and we can use coal coke in this. You're better off using coal coke if you can get away with it. We've got 64, so I'm going to use 32 and we're going to pop you in there. We're also going to need some iron, and this is going to produce steel for us. And it's very important that we get a lot of this, because I think we're going to need a buttload of it for mechanisms. So yeah, we might as well. There we go. And you know, this is a pretty slow process, much like the coal coking. I'm currently, I put a stack in there and waiting for that to do its thing. We'll, I think I'm going to avoid out the creosote oil, unless I get a quest that comes along that actually needs it. And you know, I might set up some tanks. Who knows? We have got a quest that asks us to make some iron tanks from railcraft. So maybe I'll make some of those. But yeah, you know, it's halfway there. It takes time, but it does do its job for us. So there is the blasting off again, done. We do have these ones here. So one of them's to make a steam generator so that we can make fuel that way. And the other one is to make a big tank. But I think what we're going to do is we're actually going to make our way back to Witchery, because I would like to play with Witchery. I'm actually quite into Witchery at the minute, so I would like to make some more of these. And I've made some more attuned stones, so we should be in fairly good fitting to be able to do some of these. But I think the first thing we're going to do is make ourselves a poppet shelf. I think that's going to be the plan. So let's make our way over here. We're going to need four of the attuned stones. So we'll grab four of these. There we go. And we've, oh my god, we've only got one left. Then we go through these so fast. I've got so many more infernal bricks than I actually needed. I thought I needed a lot more than that. All right, you guys can go back in there. And let's go and put our infernal bricks over here somewhere. We'll put that in there. Our hammer can go back on here. And we might as well put our bricks over here with all this stuff. Cool. Alright, so we need to make a poppet shelf. Now, a poppet shelf allows us to store our poppets on it. And it also means that they're going to function for us even though they're not on the player, which is still pretty important. So we need some nether bricks. We need our green wool. And you know what? We might as well use the rest of this. Why not? So this will give us our infernal bricks. There we go. And we're going to need some green wool. So I think what we're going to do is... And we can just dye wool, can't we? I know it sounds really sad, but I never actually make wool. Yeah, we can. Cool. So we've got 5. We're actually going to need a couple more than that. So let's get our shears out. There we go. That gives us just enough as well. We're pretty lucky right there. So that'll give us 9 of those. And I wonder if we have some green cactus. We do. Cool beans. We could use the floral dye for this as well, but hey, why not? There we go. Boom. So that gives us that, which is great. And I think that's all we need. Yes. Cool. One poppet shelf. Let's get ourselves a little table to put it on. I wonder if we have... Oh, we do. Nice. All right. So we can make an oak table. Yeah, let's do this. Let's get ourselves some... have I got any more wood in here? Got a little bit. I think we actually have enough. Yeah, we do good stuff. All right, we'll make ourselves a nice oak table. Oh, there we go. Good stuff. We should have used the witchery wood now I think about it, but hey, that's fine. So you can go here with our poppet shelf on top. Lovely jabbly. We should get some carpet as well. I don't think we have any carpet. We might do. Do we have any carpet? No. Unless it's over here. We might have some over in our Britannia stuff. Because we had to make some carpet. Yeah, we do. Cool. Yeah, we had to make some carpet to make some of the... I think it was the air ones. The air runes. No, that's not how it's meant to go. Come here. Come on, do the break. Oh, I don't want to break my chests. Let's do it this way then. There we go. Alright, I'm pretty sure we can lay carpet. Yeah, good stuff. So we'll lay our carpet on there, which is good. Pretty sure my poppet shelf has just got eaten by this. There it is. And now we can pop this on top and it will look a little bit fancier. Yeah, that looks good. Alright, so now we can put our poppets on there. And we've got a couple of poppets actually, which might be a little bit useful. We have the fire protection and the wall protection. So if we place these on our poppet shelf, like so, then if we drown by accident, we will come back to full life. It won't actually kill us. The same for burning to death, which could also be very handy. I think these do work cross-dimensionally, but don't quote me on that because I've never actually tried it. But I've also heard that these guys chunk load. I might be wrong there, but I'm pretty sure these load a chunk. So, yeah, we might have to experiment with that. But hey-ho, there we go. We've got ourselves a poppet shelf, which is very cool. Gives us a... Oh! We got a death protection poppet. That is huge. All right, let's get ourselves... Where's my bed? Come here. Come here. There we go. Sweet! All right, so I just got myself an extra life. That's pretty huge. So you can go on the shelf as well, so cool beans. I don't know which one it will actually take first, whether it goes in order. So whether like the water one would go before the death protection poppet. I would prefer it that if I was to drown, it would choose the water poppet over the death protection poppet. But I don't know, we'll have to see on that one, but cool, cool. So that's that for us, which is pretty cool. And we've also got a few other things that we want to make. So we've made ourselves our poppet shelf. We've also got the distillery and we've got the augmented attunement, which is basically giving us more foci or trinkets to place on top of our altar. Now, each one of these does require an attuned stone. I've only got one attuned stone left. And there's also the distillery and the kettle. So let's have a look at which one's probably going to be better for us. I do like the idea of the distillery. I think that's pretty cool. So we have the distillery and we have the kettle. Oh, not the eye kettle. Sounds like an Apple product, doesn't it? We want a kettle, which is like this. You know what? We're going to go with the distillery, I think. Yeah. We might actually have enough mana over there to be able to make another piece of another attune. Actually, no. No, we can make more attune stones. Yeah, I don't know what I'm on about. I'm thinking I need terra steel to make attuned stones. Don't know where that came from. All right, well, we need some gold, we need attuned stone, we need some iron, and we need some of that. I think I've got a load of these in here, and we need two. So we'll grab that. We'll grab our attuned stone. Let's make our way over here to get ourselves some iron. How many do we need? We need 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2 gold. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2 gold. Sweet. And now give us our distillery. Very nice. Oh, it looks like there's more quests here as well. So we need to make oil of vitriol. So crafting a distillery will allow you to distill fumes and other items to create more potent fumes and better refined materials. It requires natural power supplied by an altar to run. Combining quicklime with a foul fume will produce a distillate of oil, of vitriol, with gypsum and slime as byproducts. That's actually kind of big because I wanted slime. I can't remember why I wanted slime, but there's a reason I wanted slime. So foul fume, quicklime and foul fume. Okay, all right, let's just go and pop this down over here for now, so you can go there. Now, what we can do, and I'm pretty sure of this, you can put jars in there, and they kind of sit on the front of it. Yeah, how cool is that? So we'll do that. And do we have to give it fuel? I don't think we do, because it uses power, doesn't it? So we need to give it, let's have a look, vitriol. So, foul fume is oak wood. So, I wonder if we've got any of that. Foul fume. No, we don't. All right, let's get some foul fume. So, we want to get some oak wood and burn that up. And hopefully this will... Oh, look, it's Jim. I have no idea if what we called him before was Jim, but it's Jim now. And he is my Jim. There we go. You can go in there, do some things. That was right, wasn't it? Foul fume. Oak wood. Is there another way to do it? Am I going mental? Whiff of magic, tear of goddess. Oh, maybe we need to use breath of goddess in the distillery, but it doesn't work in that. So what's breath of goddess? Witch's oven and birch saplings. Okay. Oh, I think that's it. No. All right. I'm getting a little bit confuzzled. So let's get ourselves one of these. And see if that gives us what we need. Yeah, good stuff. No, 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 no. Don't go doing that again. So it was Breath of Goddess and Lapis. And this should do it for us. So let's get a little bit of Lapis. And hopefully this will give us our fume that we need. Our stench. So let's put you in there. Oh, no, that did it. That did it. Good stuff. All right. So this... I don't think this fails. I think this is like 100%, you know, like 100% jobby, so... 3230. It doesn't seem to be going down, which is also a very positive thing. Which means we're making enough to keep it going. When we put more folk art on top of it, it's going to be really good, but... That should give us some Tear of Goddess, Whiff of Magic, Foul Fume, and Slime Ball. And I don't know if it uses more of these. I think it might do. So I believe it uses 3 of them. Something like, see if it goes down to 9. Here we go. Almost done. And this will lead us onto the higher forms of fumes and whatnot. Yeah, it did. Good stuff. So Slime Ball, Foul Fume, Tear of Goddess, Whiff of Magic. I might set up some more of the storage drawers in here for all of our whiffs. Because, well, why not? So let's put you inside there. We're going to need that. And the next bit is a foul fume and a quick lime. Quick lime is wood ash. It's pretty easy, isn't it? There we go. So that and foul fume. So foul fume, quick lime. All right. And you guys can go back in there. While that's doing its thing, let us go and empty our inventory inside here. Cool beans. I still haven't found a use for this bag yet. It hasn't got anything in there. I've been carrying it around with me since we got it, and I still haven't used it for anything. We'll find something to use it for eventually, but maybe not yet. But we have actually got, you know, some good stuff in it. I'm thinking of making an enchantment table soon. There is a Britannia quest that requires us to make an enchantment table, and that will finish that quest off. I believe it's going down the route of being able to do the enchanting with Britannia, so Maybe we'll get into that at some point. I don't really need to just yet, but yeah. So that gives us slime balls, gypsum, and oil of vitriol, which should complete this quest for us. Gives us a clay jar or gas tears. Ooh. What do I want more of? Gas tears. Is there a recipe for gas tears? Well, we can do that. Okay. And what do these need? Two gas tears, rune of sloth, and extreme essence. You know, I'm going to go with the gas tears. Because the clay jars are pretty easy to make, so. Yep. We will take that. That actually gives us 64 clay jars anyway, and the gas tears. I think you'd be a bit silly to go for 128 clay jars. So, yes. But we'll do that. We'll throw those in there. We've got loads of clay jars now, which is pretty good. So let's stock these up, shall we? We'll put another 64 in there. 64 in there. Good stuff. All right, so there's that one for us. And this brings us on to a new area here, which we have guard tree. We have... Oh, man, what are these? Treefed seed. Oh, I've got a treefed seed. I actually have one of these. I traded it with a sheep. I know it sounds really silly, but I did trade it with a sheep. I'm pretty sure I got a treefed seed. Yes. Oh, man, you're not gonna... It's not gonna work, is it? Because I need to craft it. Oh, that's such a pain in the butt. But it does give me a creeper heart, and I needed one of those to be able to make the creeper seeds so that we can make the music discs, which is extremely important. Extremely important. Even though there's not a quest for it, it's very important. So witches have long been known to grow treefids as... I hope I'm pronouncing that right. I think it's treefids. As guards for their homes, you think it's time to join in the practice. I want to say triffid, just because the day of the triffids, you know, those evil trees that walk around. It does kind of look like one of that, so it might be a triffid. I don't know, but it looks like treefids. Once planted, the treefid seed will grow rapidly and act as a loyal guard for the area near its planting. Normally, they wander around or wander about when not attacking, but this behavior can be changed using a bowline. Feeding the treefid the heart of a creeper or a demon will increase its strength, or a demon will increase its strength and health. Normally, treefids will attack anything or anyone who are not their owners, but taglock kits can be given to them to prevent them from attacking the taglocked creatures. Okay. So, what's the recipe for this? We need Mutandus Extremis. We need Mandrake, Ember Moss, Tear of the Goddess, Reek of Misfortune. We can do this, I think. Let's have a look. Yeah, I think we can do this. So we need, let's have a look at the other ones. Tear of Goddess, Reek of Misfortune with magic... Tear of Goddess. So we got that one. I'm going to show you one of these at the end of the episode because these guys look hilarious. So Reek of Misfortune is older saplings, which I think we have. Yeah. So let's see if that gets us one of those. We actually have enough stuff now to make the filtered fume funnel. So I might make another one of those at some point just to give us a better chance of getting a whiff whenever we do this. Because it's pretty important. I don't want to go wasting stuff, you know. So there's those two. It's pretty big. And we needed... Let's have a look. We need a mandrake, a water artichoke, and an ember moss. Have we got all this stuff? Yeah. Got you. Artichoke. And the last thing was... one of these. Oh, man. I shouldn't have done that. There we go. Good stuff. Okie dokie. So that should be what we need to make this guy. Maybe it's going to be worth getting a crafting table around here. We haven't got one. I think it could be a fairly big idea. And I think we can do that. Have I still got my axe? What did I do with my axe in the last episode? Oh, there it is. Cool beans. Alright, let's whip this over here. So you can go probably down there. Alright, so this should allow us to make our treefid seed. Oof, gives us two more. We'll hand in the quest, which gives us our creeper heart, which is super important. I don't know if I want to hold on to this. I'm kind of thinking that making the music discs is a waste using the creeper heart. But I'm also thinking, yeah, it's a music disc. Maybe, you know, we need music in our life. It makes things go better, doesn't it? But it could be useful later on. Let's have a look at what we can use this for. We can make it into the witch's robes. We need it for gunpowder, frozen hearts, the creeper spawns, and the creeper soul. That doesn't actually look like we use it for that much. Probably am going to make music discs. I know it's a bit of a waste, but yeah, I would like to do that. So that one does that for us, makes us our guard tree. Would you like to see a guard tree? I'm pretty sure you would. So let's go over here and get ourselves a treefid or a triffid, however you want to pronounce it. Check that guy out. And he'll just wander around. I think he wants to eat the stuff. Like the last time I planted one, he kind of just stood here as well. I'm pretty definite he wants to try and eat these guys in here. Yeah, he's my treefid. We'll just let him do his thing. He's got a little tongue, little green tongue. Man, he's been eating the wrong things. So that's gonna do that for us. I think we're pretty much done there. I don't think we can go onto these just yet because we have more things to do. But we can make the kale. We can make some more of these attuned things. So if we're going to do this, then we need to get ourselves another dragonstone, don't we? Oh, we got a dragonstone. So what else did we need? Let's have a look. Attuned stone was a dragonstone, some lava, and a whiff of magic. Well, let's do that. We can do that right now, I think. Let's get ourselves some more lava. Sweet. And we'll get ourselves our whiff of magic, which we might have. Oh, we do. We got loads. That is real good. So it's you. You. And you. Gives us our attuned stone. It's pretty cool. And what should we do? Should we make ourselves another... or some, you know, like a candelabra or a chalice. Or should we make ourselves a kettle? I think a kettle could be pretty important because that opens up the gates to other stuff, doesn't it? But then again, you know, having additional power inside our altar is also pretty good. But I think we're going to make a kettle. I think. Yeah, go on, why not? So we need, if we're going to make a kettle, we need to make ourselves a crucible. Or a witch's oven, whatever they call it in this. So we'll make ourselves a cauldron, that's the one. So we'll grab ourselves one of those. And let's look at the recipe inside here. This should probably open up some more quests for us. So we need a cauldron, we need a tune stone, we need 3 string and 2 sticks. So let's get some string. Let's go get 2 more of these guys. Oh, no, I wasn't meant to do that. Instant failure. You can just go back there. There we go. So that should give us enough of those. I don't know what made me think crouching then would give it to me. I don't know. I think I had a bit of a blank moment. So that would do that. And we need to get ourselves some sticks. There we go. And this should give us our kettle. Now, I believe this kind of... looks a bit strange, and it might need fire underneath it. Something's telling me this guy needs fire. It might not do, but something says, you know, something in my brain is saying that it needs fire. So we might just break here. Yeah, I'm pretty definite this guy needs fire as well. So you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna break you and you and you. Let's go get ourselves some more netherrack. And we'll get that rocking and a rolling. So we'll pop you down there. And have I got my flint and steel? I have. Cool, cool. Hopefully this isn't going to burn the base down. You know, I do get a little bit worried when I do this. So that will do that for us. And I think that's about right. Hopefully. It looks kind of weird, like, hanging off the edge there, doesn't it? But it doesn't look pretty cool. I think if you don't have a block there, it has, like, little arms that come across. So if you put it, like, here somewhere, it might have little arms. I don't know, but it is pretty cool, isn't it? So that does that one for us. That should allow us to hand in that quest. Gives us some bottled water and some things. And I think that's going to be that. Yeah, we've got stuff for... oh, no, do we have to make the witch's robes? Oh, we do. That gives us creeper hearts. I wonder if there's an easy way to make creeper... oh, there is. We can use essence of creeper. That is so good. Because we need essence of creeper to be able to make the music discs. So I am 100% going to use that creeper heart to make the creeper seeds, the creeper soul seeds. And then we can use the essence to make more hearts. That is so good. So we're going to do that. And that will allow us to make the witch's robes. I've never actually used witch's robes before. I have used the dream catchers, because that will allow us to eventually go to the spirit realm. Whether we get a good dream or a bad dream, the nightmare or the good dream. I don't know which one it is. Yeah, there we go. Dream a little of dream of me. So you've heard whispers about a place that exists in only the most lucid dreams. It's said to be a reflection of the one you walk. And as such, you think it may contain clues regarding what happened to the world. Brewing may well be the way to achieve a means of getting there. I wonder what we actually need for a brew of sleeping, because this is pretty important. This is going to make us go to another dimension. We need a brew of sleeping. Let's have a looky see. So this is going to require some purified milk, whiff of magic, a cookie, icy needle, water artichoke, and a brew of love. So any cocoa beans, whiff of magic. We could make that. It's not that bad. Golden carrot. What's a purified milk? Just milk with odor of purity, which is hawthorn. Yeah. All right. So maybe in the next episode, we'll make our way to the spirit realm. See whether we get a good dream or a bad dream. Chances are we're probably going to get a bad dream to start with, because we need to get ourselves the wispy stuff to be able to make the, I believe it's like the particular dream catcher, or like the wispy things we need to be able to place around so that we get a better chance of getting a good dream. But hey, that's going to be enough for today's episode, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. Have yourself a great day. Have a good one, as always, and bye-bye.